guys and girls, my name's Dan and welcome back to The Forge. In this episode of Trust Me, I'm a Blacksmith, I want to remake a video. So a little over 4 months ago, I produced my first video and put it up on YouTube, and it was me making a bottle opener and a little hole punching tutorial. And the quality was terrible. I'm not going to lie, the quality of my videos isn't the best in the world at the minute, but I'm trying and I want to get them better, so I'm working towards that. But that video in particular, the image quality is very poor. Now I'm going to go over that again, and I'm going to do a slightly different way of tutorial. I'm going to make it and talk it at the same time. Whether or not this will be as comprehensive or as good, I don't know. But bear with me, I am trying. I really would like to produce some really great videos for you guys. I really enjoy doing it, and I hope you enjoy watching them. So basically, I've got a piece of 25 by 5mm mild steel, or inch by quarter inch mild steel. I've got a length here so I can hold it in the fire and I don't have to mess around with it, stick it between my legs if I need to. So that is the first thing. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take a piece of, this is welder's chalk or compressed chalk or French chalk, and I'm going to use this to find a point on the bar which is halfway in on the bar. So that's 12.5mm, and then 12.5mm down. I'm going to mark a point, pop it with the centre punch, and then I'm going to use a slitting punch, which is the tool I use to punch the hole through the bar, to mark it up so when it's hot I can find it. If you want French chalk, you can find this at a welding supplier's, and the same goes for the centre punch and the square I'm going to use. Go down to your local welding supplies or your metal stockist sometimes, if they're sort of like an ironmonger's. They should have some basic tooling and they should have some compressed chalk. They might sell it to you by the bar, they would sell it to you by a box. But I think I've got a box of like 300 of the bloody things. So, cool. Right, I'm going to get on and get this video made. One other quick point. For the hole punching, you're going to need a bolster plate. This is a bolster plate. It's got a series of increasing hole sizes. You're going to need a slitting punch, and you're going to need a round punch. I punched the hole slightly differently in the first video, so I will make efforts to comment on both techniques. I hope I remember to do that. Slitting punch. This has a 12mm end, and basically, I'm going to use a slitting punch because it punches, it cuts away a very small amount of material compared to a round punch, and therefore you get a lot of wall on your a lot of wall to the punched hole, so you're a lot to work with. Also, I punch holes a little bit differently to some people. I don't use the hardy to push them through. It distorts the back of the hole quite a bit. And it can have some funny effects on the work. It also leaves a cleaner wall punching this way. But you know, try it, suck it and see. Not everyone works the same. Right, that's it. See you in a minute.
So basically I'm going to find the centre of the bar. So the first thing I'm going to do is find 12.5. So that's 10, 11, 12 and a bit. Just there. And then I'm going to come down 12.5. One, two, just here, like so. Oh, okay, so the drop seize.
Take a hammer,
place this just here where the mark is. Now, when you do this, use your common sense. I've marked it up and it doesn't look quite in the middle, so I'm just going to move that over a little bit, like that. I'm going to take the slitting punch. I'm going to hold it on there like so, and okay, that's not bang on, but it's better than nothing, like so. Right, let's get this hot. Okay, so she's nice and warm. I'm just going to tuck her between my legs, and give it a crack, just have a look. Yeah, it looks in the middle to me. Flip her over. There's a little cold spot there. You can see that. Flip her back over. Okay. And then last one. just this side once more. Keep going until this slug releases. It'll work hard eventually. There it is, there, little tiny slug, hardly any material whatsoever. Which means I've kept loads of material in the wall. So I'm gonna get that hot again. Back between the legs again. I've got the bolster plate here and this round punch. Now I can use this round punch to center myself up a little bit should I need to, but I don't. Now it's important to work warm. The change in sound also meant that the punch started to touch on the side of that bolster plate on that hole. And they've released off there, like so. Okay, so I punched through this way the first time, and what I'm gonna do now is turn it over and punch through the opposite side. That change in sound means that it's touched. I'm gonna release that off. I'm gonna take that out as well. It's ever so slightly over on one side, so I'm just gonna quench that side off. So I'm gonna put this back in the fire with this side sticking out so it's not gonna get hot. So I've just taken this out of the fire, and as you can see, this side's slightly colder than this side. I'm gonna drop in the hole. Give her a couple of taps, have a good look. And it's moved over ever so slightly. And now I'm gonna put it all back in the fire. Okay, it's all in the fire. Just chuck that in there. That's touched. Now hopefully this will fit over the end of the Bic, and it does very nicely. So get this nice and warm and take the corners in, and the same on the opposite side. Flatten it all out, and then just work round. Working that round, all the way round. I'm going to turn it over and do the same the other side, all the way round. And then make sure you keep it nice and... This wants to stay the same thickness as the bar that's starting stock. Choking up on the hammer and working into the cooler temperatures. Just so I can planish it up ever so slightly. Like so, looking nice. Next step is to form a little chamfer around the outside. Tighten it up again. A little shab from there, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to stand it up and just give it a couple of taps and give it that iconic bottle opener shape. Now when I want to bump this up, I'm going to jam my leg in behind it like so. Just like that. Now for the next part, I need to make the little thumbnail-y bit that clips onto the back of the bottle lid. And for that, I'm going to use a round nose punch. Okay, so I've taken her out of the fire and just pop her between my legs. Just going to move that slightly. Thank you.
This is too cold really to do this, but I'm just going to mark it up. So I'm going to put my hammer on the work. I'm going to lay my punch on the back of the hammer so I can line it all up. Just give it a nice tight crack. Just check it's in the middle. And I'm just going to heat that up again. Okay, between the legs again, find that centre, and forge your little thumb, just there. So I'm just going to grab my brush, give it a nice brushing. Now at this point, if you need to, you can take a file and clean this up, or a grinder, depending on your preference. It doesn't bother me, it bothers some people. But that's basically how you make a bottle opener. The rest now is completely up to you. Now for the next part, I need to make the little thumbnail-y bit that clips onto the back of the bottle lid. And for that, I'm going to use a round nose punch. Okay, so I've taken her out of the fire and just pop it between my legs. Just going to move that slightly. Okay, this is too cold really to do this, but I'm just going to mark it up. So I'm going to put my hammer on the work. I'm going to lay my punch on the back of the hammer so I can line it all up. Give it a nice tight crack, just check it's in the middle, and I'm just going to heat that up again. Okay, between the legs again, find that centre, and forge your little thumb, just there. So I'm just going to grab my brush, give it a nice brushing. Now at this point, if you need to, you can take a file and clean this up, or a grinder, depending on your preference. It doesn't bother me, it bothers some people. But that's basically how you make a bottle opener. The rest now is completely up to you. So I'm just going to neck in here. Just going to take it up to the back of the bottle opener, just a couple of mil forward, and I'm just going to neck in. Flip her over 180, same again. Gives me a nice little neck there. Now all I'm doing is just taking that taper on the back side down. Just to give it a more bottle opener shape. Good brush in. Okay, so I'm going to take the bottle opener, I'm going to turn it over so that the little tab for the bottle opener is facing in to the anvil. And just where it becomes the inch size, I'm just going to take this chisel, give it a nice whack. And again. And again. Just get that hot. Same again, but I'm just going to lay them on here now on the aluminium. So I can cut through. Take a pair of flat-bit tongs, grab hold of the bottle opener, give it a good bend. the breaker off. This is encourages a little lip on here. I'm just going to whiz that off with a raft. Okay, so what I'm just going to do is I'm just going to forge this in ever so slightly, bring it down to a nice taper. And then I'm just going to take the side off. Give it a bit of decoration. I'm just basically hammering a chamfer on. Just because I like the way it looks and feels in the hand. Now just to form it up ever so slightly, so I'm going to put it back in the other way round this time. I'm going to get myself a slightly larger set of flat bits. I'm going to place the bottom jaw of the flat bits on the nib on the anvil, and then I'm going to give this a crack. That gives her a little kink, like so. Brush her off. Turn around and pop her in the other way round on the fire. Just going to take her over the horn thick and put a little curve in her like so. Just sit her on the anvil. Just make sure she sits nice and flat. Just like so. And that's how you forge a bottle opener. Now, I'm just going to let this cool down nice and slowly, and I'm going to use some beeswax, rub that over there, and I'll see you in a minute. Okay guys, so that's how you forge a bottle opener. I really hope you enjoyed this video. I really enjoy making them, so remember to like and subscribe. And if you'd like to win this bottle opener, I'm going to give it away to one lucky person. Now, at some point in the video, some googly eyes will have flashed up that are on my power hammer. You need to write down in the comments that you saw the googly eyes, and then write, and then subscribe if you're not already subscribed. And then I will ask one lucky random person who I'll pick some random way. I'll ask them what time they saw the googly eyes at. If they reply in the comments with the right answer, they will win the bottle opener, and I'll ship it anywhere in the world. So if you want to win the bottle opener, you've got to subscribe, you've got to write "I saw the googly eyes" or something like about googly eyes, and then I will comment on there and I'll say, "What time did you see the googly eyes?" And you comment back, "I saw them at," and then write the time. And I will send you this bottle opener, but you must be subscribed. Now let's see if she works. This is a bottle of German wheat beer. I do like my German wheat beer. Oh, she works. She's a winner. Okay guys, thanks for watching. I will chuck the original video up here of me making the bottle opener. And I'll also chuck a video of me making a toasting fork recently, and I'm going to finish this beer and head off home. Thanks for watching guys, bye bye.